Waking up this morning, I smile. 24 brand new hours are before me. I vow to live fully in each moment and look at all beings with eyes of compassion.
Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Emma, and what we do is use some of the wisdom from some of our favorite celebrities and influencers to help us on our own journey towards self-development, self-growth, self-care, and mindfulness. So if that sounds like your sort of vibe, be sure to hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell, and hit the like button. You know how YouTube is with the algorithm. Now, over the past couple of weeks, five years, we've been going through a lot. We had the whole pandemic, we had lockdowns. Now we're in a war, but there's definitely a lot of talk about war and war happening all over the world. And it's a lot. And I definitely personally feel like this is some sort of spiritual warfare, as well as obviously all the physical war that's been happening. And within that, it can cause a lot of anxiety, a lot of uncertainty. And whilst this week I was meant to do another video on Britney Spears, I was definitely called to speak about peace, and more about inner peace and how we can all find peace throughout all of the chaos that's happening in the world.
Protect your energy.
Now, as you know, we like to use a case study to kind of discuss these different matters, and today I wanted to use singer-songwriter Jhene Aiko.
Hi.
I hope I pronounce her name right. If not, sorry girl.
My name is Jhene Aiko.
She does speak a lot and she seems to exude just a level of calm, a level of peace. She speaks a lot about meditation and using sound frequency in her music for healing. And I think hearing some tips from her would be really handy for us to see how we can incorporate a bit more peace into our life on a daily basis, particularly in these turbulent times. So let's get into the first tip. Tip one, of course, is sound. So Jhene has spoken a lot about using singing bowls and different frequencies to tap into the different chakras within our body to make us feel certain things or to activate certain things. I'm sure all of us, we're blessed to be able to listen to music, right? And you know how different forms of music, different genres, different artists can make you feel different things. You listen to a pop tune, you feel a certain way. You listen to certain hip hop tunes, you feel a different way. You want to go out and get turned up. You might put on Meg, whoever, who gives you that vibe of confidence. So we all know how sound and music have a different effect on us.
It took me a while to understand that one of my purposes as an artist is to help aid people in the healing process. And so I've just been studying how sound can be a form of healing, and I'm incorporating these healing instruments into the music so that I can really put that intention into my music to heal.
Now, when we're talking about peace and incorporating a bit more peace into our lives in the concept of sound, what I tend to do, which I find is super helpful, is to create playlists. So playlists on whatever streaming platform that you use, one specifically for calming music or ambient sound. Just have something you can go to that when you are feeling a bit anxious, you can put it on and it helps to calm you down. Take a look at different frequencies, what those frequencies mean, how those frequencies make you feel, and create a playlist based on that.
This is one of my favorites. This is a crystal singing bowl in the key of C, which helps balance the root chakra.
Also, another bonus tip for this is nature sounds. Now, it's been scientifically proven that people being in nature helps them keep calm, and that's to do with all the senses. It's to do with sound, with smell, with sight. Being in nature just helps to calm you down, particularly if you're like me and you live in a highly and densely populated city. Now, sometimes we can't always get to nature, but what I do find helps is finding those nature sounds, bird songs, fire crackling, waves, those sort of things really help to calm the mind. So tap into that, find some of them on YouTube, do a little bit of research on frequencies and songs, and just know how different music affects you. for me, definitely, if I'm feeling anxious, like I'm not listening to particular songs or particular artists because they're going to send it up there. Or if I'm feeling sad or depressed, I'm not listening to no Billie Eilish because I'm not trying to be on the come down. See how sound is affecting you on a daily basis, but also incorporate it into your life so you can feel a bit more at peace.
I think with meditation, it was the same thing. When I felt how it made me feel, then I was like, okay, this is something that I want to exercise. I want to practice this because I can feel, you know, physically, mentally, spiritually, everything. I just feel better.
Now, I know a lot of people have spoken about meditation, and I know there's a lot of kind of feelings about it and around it, and people do it in different ways. For me, meditation is just about being still and being present. Yes, you can meditate for half an hour and do your visualization. Yes, you can chant and have your mantras and do meditation in that way, or listen to music, as we just spoke about sound. But honestly, it's just about taking time to yourself and being present with yourself. Often there are times when people speak about meditation, speak about clearing your mind and clearing your thoughts. But for me, that's not what meditation's about. It's not about clearing your mind. It's about getting those thoughts in some sort of order. With everything that's going on in the world today, I think it is super hard to like clear everything out of your mind. But I think it's about being present and taking the time to put those thoughts in order, to understand what is actually going on in your mind and coming to terms with it and accepting it. So take time out, whether it's 3 minutes a day, 5 minutes, 20 minutes, however long you can take, just to be still, to be in the moment and to take time to understand your mind. Definitely do that. It will definitely help bring you a bit more peace, and if not just peace, but it gets you away from the chaos of everything that's going on all around you. Step three is to disconnect. Now, I know particularly with the war that's happening in the world at the moment, a lot of us want to keep up to date on what is happening on the hour, by the hour, just so that we can be prepared if we need to. If you are like into prepping like me, you want to know what's going on, you want to like be watching the right news channels, the right prepping channels, whatever it may be, just so you feel ready should anything happen and you're not on the back foot. Totally get that. However, when you find that being involved and watching the news too much is causing you stress and anxiety, when watching certain YouTube commentary is causing you stress and anxiety, disconnect from it. And this is not even just in relation to the war. This can be in relation to gossip, it can be in relation just to anything that lowers your vibration and lowers your mood. Now naturally we can turn off the TV and just walk away from it, that's fine. What I really recommend is to do a digital detox at least once every 2 weeks. Just pick one day where you're going to focus on something else and disable all your social media. That's Instagram, TikTok, all of it. Just so that you can be, again, present in the moment and not be so involved in everything else that's going on in the world. I do it once a week on a Sunday, where you can just sit down and find something else to do, find something to indulge in. And I'm not even speaking about screen time. If you want to put on a Netflix film and watch that, opposed to scrolling through social media, do that. You want my love, be who you wanna be. Speak, 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 be free. Now, for the next tip, for those of you who know, I am a huge fan of journaling. Now, I do journal for manifestation, but also I take it as a part of my meditation practice. To be able to sit down and get thoughts out of my head onto paper has been really, really a calming and peaceful experience for me, to get my thoughts into some sort of order and able to write them down, to be able to express myself and not have everything trapped in my mind. Because we can't control everything that's happening around us, just getting it down onto paper allows us to see how we can then find coping mechanisms or how we can move forward and move past those anxiety or, you know, anything, the depressive feelings that we're feeling. It just allows us to have it on paper, read through it, and then make actionable steps to get through those feelings. And I'm not saying to journal every day. It might be, again, like the digital detox, to journal once a week, but just again finding that time for self as part of your self-care is, you know, really instrumental in incorporating peace into your being. The next step is breath work. Now, sometimes meditation and breath work can be crossed over, but I'm going to speak about breath work in a different sense. Now, it has been scientifically proven to really help release signs of trauma and PTSD. And ultimately, what it is just practicing how to breathe a bit more deeply and to breathe into our lungs. And with that, it kind of slows down the heart rate, particularly if you're feeling anxious, and allows the blood to flow. So some of the benefits of breath work are alkalizing your pH balance in your body. If you've done any research on food and the food that you eat, alkalizing the pH balance in your body just helps the reduction of mucus and better cell and organ function. So breathing deeply and practicing breath work is great just as an overall health benefit. Another benefit is anti-inflammatory effects and, of course, elevating your mood, as we're talking about finding peace. So again, I would definitely do research on breath work. There's lots of different videos on YouTube about how to practice breath work efficiently and effectively. But yeah, that's something that you can definitely do on a daily basis to help calm you down. So my final tip is to read or use Audible. Now, this isn't sponsored by Audible, by the way. We'll get there one day.
Peace is every step. And I read it probably in 2 or 3 days. It was so simple, so poetic. And I applied it immediately. And I just felt good. You know, I felt good. I felt happy. And from there on, I would always get his new books and give them to people.
A lot of the bulk of my knowledge and the things that I implement in my day-to-day life just to be a bit more calm and content has been through some books. So I've put links below in the description box below just of different books that have been really helpful for me on my journey. But just to discuss a couple here, of course, The Alchemist. A lot of people and a lot of celebrities and successful people have spoken about The Alchemist, but it's just a really great book on kind of trusting the journey and going with the flow and being at peace with the way life is rather than trying to fight against the tide. So The Alchemist is a great book if you want to kind of delve into more about mindfulness. So the next book is The Miracle of Mindfulness. And the author of this book has many different books that have been instrumental in helping me develop more mindfulness. And he also had a YouTube channel. He's passed away now, but he also has a YouTube channel that is steeped in kind of Buddhism practice, but it's also just outside of religion. It's just techniques you can apply to your everyday life just so you feel a bit more calm. And a lot of the books that I've put below and the ones that I'm recommending here do tend to speak about letting go.
I was telling you I was gonna get you that book, The 7 Spiritual Laws of Success.
Yes.
By Deepak Chopra.
Yeah, I've seen that book.
So there's 7 laws, but my favorite one is the law of least effort. It's basically like going with the flow and having faith in the universe.
Kind of go with the flow.
Yeah.
And when it comes to everything that's going on in the world and all the anxiety and uncertainty we feel, if we can't control it, try not to get stressed about it. What you can control is how you react to certain things, how you ingest and how much you take in of certain things that are going on around you. That's what you can control. So work on that opposed to being super worried about the things that are just down to the politicians and governments. I know they don't know what they're doing, but we can't do anything about it. So we have the empathy, we give the charity where we can, and we work on ourselves. If we work on ourselves to develop peace, and then we spread the knowledge to other people, then hopefully peace and love will override all the bullshit that these governments and politicians pull. That is the dream, that is the hope. Okay, bonus tip that I totally forgot, that's turned back on the camera, just to let you know, is have your morning and night routine down. I know a lot of people talk about routines in terms of productivity, but it's also really imperative just to make sure that your routine works for you, just in terms of you being calm and being at peaceful, not even just peaceful, just in terms of you being content. Having a morning routine that is steeped in things that you love, not rushing around to get to work, not rushing around with the kids, but taking some real time for yourself, even if it's just 10 minutes, just for you to breathe, whether you want to meditate, whether you want to journal, have a morning routine down that allows you that time before you get into the chaos of the day. For me, I just do something simple. I make my tea, I look out the window and I drink my tea. That's it. Nothing drastic, nothing dramatic. But that really raises the serotonin in my body. It makes me feel happy. I get to hear the birds, a bit of nature. And it allows me to give gratitude because I've made the time to do so. But it also allows me just to appreciate the smaller things in life before I get into my day. So having a routine, night and morning set, is a bonus tip for helping you incorporate that peace daily.
I vow to live fully in each moment and look at all beings with eyes of compassion.
So that's a wrap for my video on how to find peace in your everyday life. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any friends that are feeling anxious or uncertain about certain things, please send them on these tips. Or if you end up reading anything, please put it in the comments below. If you've got any tips on how to be more peaceful in everyday life, let us know, because we're all going through a lot. We're all feeling the effects of the past, I want to say couple of years, but it's really been 5 years. All these elections, police brutality, everything, a lot's been thrown at us, man. So any tips that any of us can give to help us be a bit more peaceful, a bit more mindful in our day-to-day life so we can cope with this bullshit would be welcome. So I'll see you next week on another video where I am going to do Britney Spears, I promise you, and coping with toxic family members and friends. But until then, have a good week, detox from social media, and I'll see you when you're back on your social media kick and YouTube next week. Peace out.
Calm down eventually.